So my salvation story, I think for me, I remember specifically when I had graduated from university and I was working, that was like in another country. And basically as I was going to work on that particular day, I had a car accident, which could have been very, very bad, but thank God it wasn't. But then I think that experience basically got me thinking, okay, what do I, like, if something had gone sideways, where would I be? And I think that major question just got me thinking deeply and just, you know, trying to just reenact that relationship. And just all the conversations that we had had growing up, like, oh, read your Bible, pray every day. And it got me asking, okay, do I really know God? And I basically just jumped into the Word, right? I'm like, okay, you know what, let me jump into His Word to see what this Bible actually says. It's very easy to just attend church without having an actual relationship. And so, in just studying the Word of God, I began to just see His love for me. And just, it's like the Word was speaking to me, essentially. And I just rededicated my life back to Christ, saying, God, you know what? I'm sold out for you from this moment here on. And that's how I gave my life back to Christ. And that was my salvation story. So in tying it into Easter and this season that we're in, I would just say that knowing what Christ went through in studying the Word, just for me. Now, I know He died for everybody, but then this is my personal story. So I'm saying just all He went through for me, and seeing that just made me just fall in love with Him more and more. And obviously we're still on that journey, just growing daily and just trying to learn more, as God and the Holy Spirit helps us to do. So that's my salvation story. And I hope this inspires someone to just, you know, dive deeper into more of what God has for us. And yeah, that's my salvation story.
So my salvation story, well, the thing about my salvation story is that I would normally say it's not straight, it's very ziggy-zaggy. And I say this because I've always grown up in the church. I had the privilege of having Christian parents, and so we'd always do morning devotions, pray in the evening, go to church. So that Christian culture is what I've always known my entire life. And so it wasn't until I was 10 years old that I started getting curious about who this person we're always praying to is. Like, who is this person, right? And I was curious about the Bible. And so I started reading my Bible, started being intentional about my relationship with God. However, I was always that person that was repenting every week. Anytime that we'd have an altar call, I would go out, be like, oh God, I'm so sorry, I'm sorry, da, da, da. Rededicating my life to Christ every week, meeting Jesus every week over and over. And from my relationship with God, I came to an understanding that it's kind of like a friendship. It's very awkward if you have a friend that you're always introducing yourself to every time. Hey, my name is this, what's your name? Hey, my name is this, what's your name? But that's what I was doing every time I was repenting every week. I came to an understanding that I'm actually invited into a walk with God. And so what that means is that when I accept the gift of salvation, I actually have given Jesus the right to be Lord over my life. And so I don't have to keep reintroducing myself to Him because He already knows who I am, right? He just wants me to keep walking with Him. And so that's how I was able to deal with, like, not always being perfect, because when we receive salvation, it doesn't mean that we're automatically going to stop doing the things we used to do or we're going to become these saints. But we actually receive the righteousness of Christ. And so we are able to walk in Him. My story, as I've considered it, is that I have a friend, I have a lover, I have someone that is everything to me. God is everything, and yet manages to be excellent at everything. If that makes a lot of sense to me in my salvation, because I know that there's been times where I've needed a teacher, literally. And God would teach me a concept that I needed to understand. There's been times where I needed a father and God would father me. There's also been times where I needed a mother. Like, as much as I love my parents, right? But he shows me that he encompasses that role far more than any person can. There's been times where I've needed a friend, right? And he's been my best friend throughout. So that, to me, is what salvation is about. It's accepting Christ and accepting his lordship over me, and then also being called into a walk with him, where we have a fellowship, where honestly, there's been times where he's like a therapist. You know, there's times where you can't load a lot of the things you're feeling onto someone, because that's a lot for someone else to take. We call it trauma dumping now, but you can never trauma dump on God, right? So that's what salvation is to me. And that's why this Easter season is so good, because it reminds me that there is a story that I can tell about my salvation. And I just wish that more people had access to God in the way that I have access to him. And you can have access to him when you accept him as your Lord and Savior.
In May 2016, I reluctantly decided to attend a summer camp for young people and young adults in the community. And I was invited prior, about a couple months before, but I wasn't really leaning towards going, and I was looking for excuses not to go. However, I ended up being encouraged by my family as well as my brother at the time. I wasn't necessarily well grounded in my faith, but I decided to give this a shot, not for the right reasons, but more so to socialize and meet people. However, in my time and in my experience there, I experienced this deep calling spiritually and yearning for Christ that resulted in an altar call during a sermon where I went up reluctantly, not really understanding what it meant. But I remember experiencing a deep rushing power of the Holy Spirit that day that sort of convicted me. And I think it has been a long-lasting conviction even until this day. Where deep down inside, I know who I am as a child of God. I know that Jesus Christ has died for my sins, and I believe these things truly, and that I have now been made righteous in God's eyes by the death and the suffering that Jesus Christ experienced for me on the cross. And for that, I am eternally grateful, because the Bible says in Romans that, you know, by our works alone, we're like filthy rags and we're condemned to but with Jesus Christ and his death, we have been made righteous in God's eyes. And I am eternally grateful to God for that. This Easter, I'm excited for the opportunity again to celebrate the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ and what that means even 2023 years later and forever and beyond until Jesus comes again. We get to celebrate this every year, and I hope you are also as excited as I am.
My salvation story. I grew up in church, basically. I always look at myself like a PK, a preacher's kid. I was not a preacher's kid. My mommy was just one of those women that loved to eat, sleep, breathe, walk, live in church. So I was always in church, and I just grew up around this community of like Christians, and so I was a Christian. Never really gave my life to Christ though. One thing about church that they don't tell you, there are so many hypocrites in church. And so I wanted to run away from church. I didn't want to be there. I didn't want to be associated with it. I didn't want to see, smell, hear. Anyways, let me stop giving you guys. But I just didn't want to be in church, and that's what I did. I came to school in Canada from Nigeria, and I was running as fast as my legs could carry me. If God was there, I was running. I was running away from the King of the Universe. Is that not foolish? I was running, and I just made so many like stupid decisions. But God chased me. When I say God chased me, I'm not going to have enough time to explain to you how God pursued me. But he chased me. And when I was at the lowest of lows, when I was the worst I've ever been. When they broke my heart, I said yes to Christ. And, you know, it was so special to me because nobody preached to me. Nobody said anything to me. I was done crying in the shower and I came and I saw Transformation Church, like Pastor Mike's YouTube. I've never searched that before. But that was God calling me, chasing me, calling my name. And that just says so much about the God that we serve and this moment that we are in right now, like the Holy Week. God loves us so much. He sent His Son to die for us. His only begotten Son. His Son died and resurrected. And He said, no, we're not going to stop there. I'm going to chase you. See, Faye, I will chase. And that's what He did. I mean, I don't know if you guys can relate, but, you know, for my ladies out there, you know that guy that you keep telling no, but he's still... Sorry, I just saw that meme of like, why are you running? Why are you running? That one where they're chasing you. But you know when like someone is so intentional and mindful, that is who my God is. Like, even when I didn't want to hear anything God was for me. He loved me. He put me in the right spaces. And I'm just so thankful. In this season that we're in of Easter, I'm just so joyful because God cares so much about me. He loves me. He's mindful of me. And He's mindful of you too. That's what Easter means to me. The love of God personified in His Son that He sent to die for us. I don't know about you guys. I'm joyful. Eh? When you see me out there, I'm gonna be jumping. Because my Jesus gave His life for me. And, you know, I just want to say, if you are running away from the King of the universe, you don't want to give your life to Christ. If you're like me and you're chasing men instead of the man of your heart, He's gonna find you. He'll find you. He'll find you. So just come to Christ. Come to Christ. Come so that they'll not drag you, eh? Because He'll still find you the way that He found me. Love you guys.